playing so many sets in the night and like playing throughout everybody's set and being on stage or nearby for all 3.5 hours of the night, it definitely feels like a marathon. But I also feel like it adds to what makes, for us at least, what makes the night so fun and what makes it work. We end up feeding off each other a lot, and by the end of the night when we're all on stage together and it's Middle Brother, it's sort of like reached its, you know, its pitch, and it's sort of like, it all turns into just a bunch of laughs and jokes and having a good time together.
Do y'all ever feel like you're wearing everybody out? I always get the feeling, I'm like, this is kind of intense. This is a lot to put people through. And then you look out and you're like, are y'all worn out? Do you want to go to bed? Should we stop or something?
But they see, I mean, yeah, like, we keep doing, we keep coming out and they stay till the end and stuff. So, but
it's chaotic for everybody involved.
It's a recession special is what it is.
Good kind of chaos.
It's a good deal.
I was definitely surprised by the learning how we all wrote, but getting to know John and Johnny as songwriters, it was definitely a learning experience for me, because I've always been the guy that like I finished this song, it took me 2 months, and that's a fine pace for me. And watching how John would write much faster than I would, that off the cuff like nature of the writing was really represented in the finished product. And like that week, I wrote a bunch. Those 2 weeks, I wrote like 3 songs in 2 weeks. I had never done that. So readjusting my perspective on the different ways you can write a bunch of songs, like that month was a big game changer for me.
Well, do you remember when you were first coming to Nashville? You were like, this is the whole idea. We're there for a month. We're gonna write for 2 weeks and then record for 2 weeks.
Yeah, but it was also like terrified because
I was like, holy shit, how's this, like, wow, I'd love to see how this works out. And then you're like, the first day I went over to the house, you were like, all right, check out these 8 songs. It's like, god damn, man.
It was great to have just other people there writing. Like, Johnny would pop in every now and then. Basically, it was me and Taylor sitting around a dining room table, like, each of us with a guitar and, like, a notebook. It's just like, got something yet? when we got into something, you know, if like you got stuck writing and just be like, dude, check this out, like help me out with this. I need a line or I need a bridge or something. And so there is a lot of uncredited co-writing on the album where Taylor and I kind of helped, I don't know, you know, dot the I's and cross the T's or whatever, snort the lines and drink the beers.
The growing and the challenging parts and the most interesting parts, they're all different and varying from each of us. But it's when you just take a song and that maybe doesn't necessarily work with the band, or you take a song and then you add it to these other guys that have opinions on it, where these guys are just like, oh, it sounds like a soul song, let's play a soul song, that sounds great. Nothing more to that, I like the song, let's just do that. And it's just straight songwriting. Taylor's been saying, you know, it's the idea. Like, your first inclination is usually the right answer, you know, it's the right solution, and that's what we went off on this record.
Yeah, we're just trying to have a party and, like, trying to let you know that our experience here making this record was as fun as possible.